Hey, thanks for clicking on the extended version of my cast interviews for Me Before You. If you're a Game of Thrones fan, you love Emilia Clarke. Boy, she had a good season in that TV series. In this film, she plays kind of a quirky, not homely necessarily, caretaker who has to take care of a man who's paralyzed. He ends up falling for her. He's played by Hunger Games hottie Sam Claflin, and I had a chance to sit down with both of them, as well as the writer and the director of this very sad tale.
Oh, he hates me. Every time I speak, he looks at me like I'm stupid.
To be fair, you are pretty stupid.
Yeah, but he doesn't know that yet.
They gave us these. They're tissues.
Oh! They're the tissues I've heard so much about.
When was the last time you all went through a box of tissues watching a movie? What was that movie that did it for you?
I think you sobbed. The first, where I sobbed, it would have to be The Notebook. The first time I saw The Notebook, I mean, it was uncontrollable. I remember calling my girlfriend at the time going, this is like me and you. You meant to be with me. Yeah.
Did you marry that one or did...
No. No. She's long gone. One. No. she dumped me after I sobbed.
It's like, who's this wuss I'm dating?
Move closer. You smell fantastic.
I cry really easily, genuinely really easily. But like the good Sleepers in Seattle always gets me every time. But those are happy tears. A lot of my crying uncontrollably is happy tears. And then Stepmom, no, with the horse.
Oh, I know.
Just say goodbye.
Yeah. It's, we're gonna start crying in about 2 seconds. Thank you for the tissues. By the way,
I could have used these. Special themed Kleenex. Yeah.
I could have used these before the movie, not so much at the junket, because I'm hoping that you don't make me cry. But when was the last time that you actually went through a box of tissues watching a movie?
Oh wow, a
box. Probably in the edit suite. Sorry, but yeah, it's just, you know, it's completely different when. You know, it's one thing writing the thing, but when you see the actors bring it, and there's all the emotion and there's the music and Thea's direction, and I sit there and I still cry every time I see it. Loving can hurt.
For me also, it's that song. There are a couple of songs now that are so,
Ed Sheeran, come on. You put that song in anything in your movie.
High five to Ed Sheeran, big
time. Thank you, Ed.
I mean, come on. And then you didn't just do it once. You do it more than once in this movie. Yeah. I'm like, oh, no.
Here it comes again.
I don't do much, okay? I go to work and I go home and that is it.
In preparation for this, I went back and rewatched Love Story. And I did go at that. I did really go at that.
I think my worst ever crying session was The Champ. Do you remember The Chair with John
Hurt? Oh my gosh, come on,
exactly. I remember being knocked out for a whole afternoon by that one. It's just like lying on the sofa in a fetal position.
And what if I said I didn't want you here?
I'm not employed by you. I'm employed by your mother.
Your character has to win him over. When you all want to win someone over, what's kind of your go-to? How hard do you work at it?
I don't...
I work annoyingly hard to the point where they're like, it's having the opposite effect. Stop making the tea. Stop doing the eyebrows.
Right.
Get out. Stop trying to help me do something that I don't need your help with.
You're scaring me at this point.
Yeah pretty much. That's exactly
it. Weirdly positioned.
Obsessed. Yeah, I'm not very good.
Just be myself, you know.
Oh my
God. Just charming old Sam.
I'm kidding. I'm totally kidding. I try to be funny. I think I'm a goofy guy, and I'm not afraid of being goofy. I don't think anyone should be. I try to make people laugh.
I'll bet it works.
First girl I ever kissed was on that rampart.
Probably didn't hurt that you owned the castle.
I know it was hard for you. I mean, you can't really move, and I'm sure you learned all the things that we tend to take for granted when we can move around very easily. Was there ever something that was really difficult? You forgot you did move, or your instinct was this, and you're like, no, you're not able to do that as your character.
There was definitely moments that I had to be reminded. Because, as you can imagine, I basically spent all day, every day, going, don't move. You know, my brain was constantly working to keep me, like, in the position that I needed to be in. There were a few moments that Thea, the director, had to kind of go, you know, your hand isn't quite in the right position, or your foot isn't, you forgot to twist your foot. So I remember there was one take where I had a hair in my face, and it was one that was going really well. But all I could think about was hair, and I couldn't in the middle, obviously, just do that. And it was so simple, something so simple, moving a hair off your face.
Although, had you done that, that would have really be a cool pivotal moment for her character.
Whoa. Yeah.
You can move down.
I'm magical.
Yes.
Do you know something, Clark? You are pretty much the only thing that makes me want to get up in the morning.
Directing the cry, because what's so nice about this is you kind of build up to this moment, and it's a close-up, and it lasts for some time, and then it's kind of that, the cry, that kind of look in your eyes thing. Is that an easy thing to direct?
Do you mean the scene on the beach, or do you mean when she's
either
on
one? They both seem, when she's sitting with him and he's kind of right. telling her, that one, the one on the beach where she's just a mess. I mean, how do you direct those scenes that are close on an actor and long, and you're like, you're feeling everything?
Well, let me tell you, I felt all of those on the day. It was pretty messy.
It was emotional.
I have to admit. But you cannot go to that place if the actors haven't gone there first. And my job as a director in the prep for this movie was to make sure that the actors were ready to go there. And if they do, and then we go while we're watching it, we know we're onto a good thing, and that's where it needs to be.
Can you tell when they reach that point? Can 100%. You tell? Really?
Yeah. If you're doing your job properly, yeah. And the hardest thing is telling them they can go again and they can do it better.
Yeah, what do they say at that point?
They go with you.
So where's better than this, then?
Paris. Place Dauphine, right by the Pont Neuf.
So let's go. We could get on the Eurostar right now.
What's on your bucket list? If you could go someplace to kind of keep you motivated and this is where I've always wanted to go, is there a place that you haven't been that's that place for you?
Yeah, Peru. I want to climb Machu Picchu real bad. Yes.
How bad? Real bad.
I'm going to put my flip-flops on. I'm going to walk up Machu Picchu.
I feel like I've been really blessed with the places that I've seen, but they're obviously... I want to go everywhere, really, ideally.
I have become a whole new person because of you.
Do you know something, Clark? You are pretty much the only thing that makes me want to get up in the morning. Wait for me to come
home. Yep. You might even need more than one box of tissues for Me Before You. It is a tearjerker. But on a lighter note, don't forget to get a hold of one of these Harkins loyalty cups. You can find them at any Harkins Theater. And in the meantime, don't forget to like us on Facebook, Harkins Theaters, for your movie news, your promotions, and everything you need to know about any giveaways we do. In the meantime, we'll see you at the movies.